Hello, this is Harpreet Singh. I just scored All India Rank 19 Civil Services Examination. And my optional was PubEd this time, and I scored 331 marks in Public Administration. In this video, I would like to tell you about my strategy of the Public Administration, how I prepared it, and more than preparing it, and it is more about how I attempted the Public Administration paper. So, when I started with the Public Administration, I was not very sure about it. I had read all the number of books that are in the markets, and but I realized with the time that this subject is not about reading so much. It is more about relating the public administration theories with the contemporary Indian administration examples. So the main focus of my preparation was making smart notes about the thinkers and how the thinkers are still valid with the in the present Indian administration context. So for the introduction, there is a normal book. This is the typical book that everyone follows. This is the Prasad and Prasad Administrative Thinkers, and I have done it. I read it so many number of times, and but everywhere when I read the book, I had the habit of jolting down the examples from the Indian administration into the book itself. So for example, when we talk about the devolution, I wrote the examples of 73rd and 74th Amendment Acts and the Panchayati Raj systems. And when we talk about the decision making, and then we talk about the decisions that are taken by the deputy magistrates and the deputy commissioners. So this is how you can write on as many examples while reading that book. So it may help you relate the thinkers with the present Indian administration that is there. So this is what I followed for the theory, the thinkers. And as far as the general idea of the public administration is concerned, I followed the book of Nicholas Henry, and this is a very beautifully written book, and usme kai cheeze itni acche se de rakhi hain. Like when you talk about the leadership, every other book you follow, it is always about the discrete leadership theories, but in that book it is very clearly mentioned that how the leadership theories evolved over the time. So that kind of thing really helped. And usually people do not go for the Nicholas Henry books, and but it helped in a lot, because it gives you a bit of an academic background to what you are writing, and you can also put those theories into the present context, or like Indian administration examples into those theories. For example, when we talk about the transformative leadership, you can quote Mahatma Gandhi, like he was a transformative leader. So these kind of examples really help. And when you are attempting the paper, it does not mean that you have to write only the paper 1 and not use paper 2 in that. So when you write paper 1, make sure that you're quoting the valid examples from paper 2. So this helps you a lot. And and of course, when it comes about the definition parts, for example, you have to talk about public administration. So there are so many different definitions, that for some people public administration means something, and for some something else. So you, for all those kind of things, I would suggest you to make sure that you write in the definitions which are contemporary in nature. For example, for the public administration, you can write the Minobrook 3 definition rather than writing something vague. So this helps you a lot. And one more important thing I would like to talk about the paper 1, it is about the organizations. So the theories are very much common, like close organization, open organizations, but as long as you are not putting in the right examples there, so it does not leave an impact on the examiner. So the main focus has to be that your answers have to be different from what others are writing. For example, in DIPP and the Department of Industrial Promotion and Policy and Department of Commerce, there is an intern based system is all being followed these days, and in DIPP, the project management invest India team is there. So they are the new organization type which the government of India is adopting. So you can quote all these kind of examples in your paper one. So I cannot focus, I cannot stress more that how much examples you have to write in paper one to score good marks. Because of this, I think I scored 162 marks in paper one, and which was much more than expected. But it really helped. And when it comes about paper two, everyone has his different techniques. People usually rely on the GS2 notes to write paper, public administration paper, which is more or less sufficient. But the thing is, you have to do a little bit extra. For example, I can just tell you about few examples. For example, the performance appraisal system is there. Since I was in BSF and I actually filled the APR report of lot many my jawans, but I knew first-handedly what are the problems with that system, that APR. Even the seniors are not aware of the juniors whose APR they are filling. So these type of personal experiences helped me a lot writing the good answers, and I quoted them extensively. And I also focused on writing facts and figures in paper two, and I realized that they actually, when you start preparing the public administration, ये बहुत redundant लगता है कि इतने सारे facts and figures को मैं क्यों याद करूँ, और ये शायद याद रहते भी नहीं हैं, but when you actually put them into practice, when you start writing your answers, join some test series, and you quote those facts and figures, those examples, those different type of things in your paper, you realize that it really helps. It actually helped me realize this in while I was giving the test series. I had joined the test series, and I started to get good marks, and I followed the same strategy in the public administration paper, and it rewarded me well, and I scored 169 paper two, and the overall score was 331, which was the really a determining factor that I scored All India rank 19. And had it not been the public administration, I don't think that how this rank was possible. There were times when we thought that public administration is being grilled by UPSC, the marks are not coming. पिछले कितने सालों से मेरे खुद के marks भी बहुत कम आते रहे हैं, और इस बार मैंने public administration का paper दिया, but मैंने काफ़ी चीज़ें अपनी उसमें change की. I just jumped from writing the totally academic answer to much more relative contemporary sort of exam the answers. So this really helped. I think if you can do these kind of things in your public administration preparation, I'm not sure that it will help or not, but it will definitely give you an improvement that what you have been scoring. So that's about my public administration strategy. If you have any more queries about public administration strategy or some confusion regarding that, you can post your queries in the comment. I would try to answer your queries. And thanks for watching Delhi Knowledge Track. This is a very good initiative, and I really admire it from my heart.